Welcome to Lankan Tutor, and we're at Biology 1.2. We do recommend that you guys do use the site, as it does have written tutorials for you which can help you through the process. So let's get into the scientific method. Now, this is the final part of the first unit, and after that we will be done. The scientific method is a standard sequence of steps, normally followed by scientists or biologists all over the world to investigate a particular event or problem. This could be in the field of biology or in your day-to-day life. It's an organized pattern of investigation. That is the definition of the scientific method. It's a bit hard to remember, but don't worry, you don't really have a choice. You have to remember that. So, how exactly does the scientific method work? Let's work this with an example. You walk into a room and it's completely dark. And the first thing you need to do is make an observation. The observation is that the room is dark. Now, based upon that observation, you make hypotheses. Let's jump into a few hypotheses right now. The first one is that there is an outage of power. That could be the reason why the room is dark. The second one is that the bulb is switched off. The third hypothesis is that there are bulbs, but the bulbs are burnt out. And the fourth hypothesis is you suddenly went blind. If you want to know what a hypothesis is, the best way to remember it as a potential explanation to a cause. So now you have the four hypotheses, you come to the experiment. For the experiment, you turn on the switch and there still is no power. Now you can reject the second hypothesis that we derived from the first, from the observation, which is the bulb is switched off. Hence, the bulb cannot be switched off if the light is switched on. So we remove the second hypothesis and we have three left. You look in another room and you can see that the other room is well lit and there is power. So with that evidence or with that experiment, we can reject hypothesis one, that there is a power outage, and we can reject hypothesis four, in which you were blind. So the only hypothesis left is the third one, which is that there are bulbs, but the bulbs are burnt out. So this hypothesis becomes your prediction. After you make a prediction, you can send it through another series of experiments, either to confirm or reject the hypothesis. So for the experiment, you take the bulb and fit it in a different socket, the previous socket in the other room where it did give out light. And it was previously working, and then you see it still doesn't light up. And then you accept the hypothesis 3 as a theory and confirm your prediction. If it were rejected, however, you will be going back to stage 2. It was about building hypotheses, and you cycle again and again till you come up with a solid answer. If an answer is accepted for a long period of time, that theory becomes a law. So that is generally the scientific method. It's what we knowingly or unknowingly use to confirm something as fact. If you take an observation, you wonder why that is happening in such a way, you back it up with theories, and you do experiments again and again and again, and remove every hypothesis you possibly can until you have one left. Now, during these experiments, there is something called setting up a control. A control is basically what you use to differentiate the experiment you're using. Let me give you an example. Let's take that you're taking a plant and putting it under a bucket, and you're going to prevent it from sunlight. Now, for us to know that the effects that's happening is from because of sunlight, you also need to have another plant which is just like that, except you don't place a bucket over the second plant. Now, in this situation, the second plant, which doesn't have a bucket on it, will be acting as the control. So you would know that it's not because of the plant that whatever your observation and conclusion you derive from this was not affected because of the plant, but it was because of the bucket you placed on top of it and how that caught sunlight. You know this because you have a control. That is the main reason that you can use controls in experiments to. It's another way to prove your point and to figure out your problem. So finally, the scientific method, if you were to explain it, this is how you would go about doing it. It's the identification of a problem which then forms the basis of a systematic observation. Posing questions and formulating hypotheses based on them, testing the hypothesis by conducting experiments with controls where necessary, making predictions and testing them by further experiments, confirming predictions supported by evidence and observation, and finally formulating a theory which may be modified in the light of new knowledge. So that is it, guys. That is the end of the entire first unit. Thank you guys for watching. And if you did enjoy this video or you found it informative, please do leave a like and subscribe to this channel for more videos regarding biology, physics, or chemistry. Tell your friends, because that does help a bunch. Again, we will see you next time on Unit 2. Unit 2 is the cellular basis of life.